Alright guys, so this is a bit of a random extra video on basically what I'm doing is similar to a shoot apical meristem technique, where normally I would do this under the microscope. I don't have a microscope with me, so I'm doing this just by looking at it as much. I'm trying to remove, so this is okay. So let me explain you. So this is a rhododendron, and what I did is I just took, I cut the on the note. You can see the shoot tip that is coming up. So I took that off, and this is what I'm using to try to introduce it to tissue culture. So this is the tip, and I'm trying to peel it up. Peel it off, remove those leaf primordia, and leave with like the shoot tip essentially. Now this is not the whole shoot apical meristem where you are only leaving the apical meristem. This is not that. I would have to use the microscope to do that kind of detailed work. Now the reason I'm doing this is because trying to sterilize a plant that has been outside is fairly difficult. So if I try to sterilize a rhododendron, it will be fairly difficult to sterilize. So I just took the very shoot tip, and then I sterilized it using bleach. And then yeah, I mean, I'm peeling this off, trying to remove those leaf primordia. And this is what I end up with it. So this is just the inside. So this should be fairly clean, where to the point that I should be able to get regenerate more plants just from this tip right here. Now this was a fairly small shoot. So this is from like the shoot that's coming out from the internodes. So next I'm going to do one from the very top. So alright, so this is the one I'm doing next. So you can probably see all this a little better, the process of what I'm doing. Alright, here we go. So this is the very tip of the plant. So I use cut it up, I sterilize it, and right now you can see a bunch of bubbles. This is from the hydrogen peroxide that I'm using just to keep it in here. But what I want to do is I want to remove these leaves carefully. Now I'm using a forceps and a scalpel. You may want to do this with two scalpels. That may be a lot easier than trying to use forceps and a scalpel, but I'll make it work. Let's see. Also, using a sharp knife will be much better. This knife is not very sharp anymore, so we'll just carry out all these leaves. So you can, sorry, I wasn't showing that. Yeah, so just carry all these leaves. And you can do this with a lot of plants, with like trees especially, like I say, they grow outside, they are very difficult to sterilize. So oh, I'm losing my voice. So this is makes it a lot easier to sterilize. So other plants that I have done this with before are like I say, these are rhododendrons. Hydrangeas, some other trees, nepenthes, like carnivorous plants, they can also be done like this. So one technique to like propagate nepenthes, or to introduce nepenthes to tissue culture, is by using hormones like cytokines, like Kinetic or BA, to induce some of these new lateral shoots. That way you can just take the lateral shoots and try to use the sterilization this way, so you don't end up essentially sacrificing the entire plant or like the entire node. So this takes a lot of patience, and good eyes. Like my vision is not the best, so like right now you're seeing from the camera, which actually I'm not sure how it looks, because I'm not looking at the camera, the screen right now from my phone. I'm just looking directly to in the plants. So I just do this bare eye. Oh, this is a good one. Okay. This is a great way to practice like a shoot tip culture with maybe some trees that you may have. You can take some branches off. You can definitely do this, especially because the apicomeric stem or the tip is easier to see and a lot easier to work with than with some other plants that are very, very small. So trees are a good candidate for practice, because you can find a lot of material and then you can just practice on your own. And I'm sorry if I keep moving this out of the view, but like I said, I'm not looking at the camera, at the screen. And looking at the plant. So this is all what it is. Use peel all those layers, as many layers as you can. Now I'm not trying to remove any like viruses on like this plant. All I'm trying to do is get it into tissue culture. But I mean, the easiest way to do it is just get rid of as many leaf primordials as I can. Just get the smaller explant possible. That was a good peel right here. The smallest explant possible, because if you get into those inner layers, they should be sterile, so that makes your percentage success of getting the plant in tissue culture a lot higher than trying to sterilize an entire node. I think that's probably as much as I'm going to be able to get. So what I need is this part. So I'm just going to cut this. Yeah, this is what I'm going to place in the media. So all of this is trash. So you can see it's pretty small. But it's not very small. I mean, this compared to other like the shoot apicomeris stem, this is massive. Like they're usually they use the tip of the blade, but this is a much bigger. So this is good enough for trees, just to remove as much inner layers. Like technically, these layers right here should be much cleaner. Hopefully sterile. Not sure if it will be completely sterile. Maybe not. But they also all the liquid, all this like water that you're looking here is hydrogen peroxide. So I doing this at the same time. They are also cleaning, doing the surface sterilization right here. So now I'm going to place this intermediate. So there it is. All right, guys. Well, that was everything for today. Hope you have enjoyed it, and I'll see you next week. Bye.
Hey, everyone. Thanks for watching the video. If you're enjoying these tissue culture videos, be sure to follow us on social media for more informative content. And if you're interested in conducting your own tissue culture experiments, make sure to check us out at plantcelltechnology.com for all the products you need to get started. Use the code FP10 for 10% off your first purchase.